Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light, split the night and touch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more.
A continuing frustration for American commanders was the enemy's ability to keep supplies flowing to Viet Cong guerrillas in the south. Often forced to travel at night over rugged jungle trails, the communists carried tons of weapons on bicycles or on their backs. This human transport system was countered by a highly sophisticated electronic strategy codenamed Igloo White.
Igloo White was an effort to sow sensors along the Ho Chi Minh Trail, the principal route for carrying arms from North Vietnam through Laos into South Vietnam. With Igloo White, aircraft dropped unmanned sensors along the trail. And then as the sensors detected movement of troops, movement of vehicles, signals would be sent up to an aircraft, would be relayed by the aircraft to a command center in South Vietnam, and then attack aircraft, bombers, fighter bombers, would be dispatched to attack those specific targets.
Igloo White has been called the Manhattan Project of high-tech warfare. After 5 years of intensive top-secret scientific work, the plan was fully operational by 1969.
Very technically successful. But when you stop to think about it, if you have a $30 million orbiting reconnaissance aircraft to transmit the signals and a $20 million command post, and you call in four $10 million fighters to assault a convoy of five $5,000 trucks carrying $2,000 worth of rice, it's easy to see that it's not cost effective. This was a self-inflicted wound. We chose to fight a high-tech war against a resourceful, low-tech enemy.
People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. No one did disturb the sound of silence. Fool said, I do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words like silent raindrops fell. Echoing the wells of silence. The people bowed and prayed to the neon god they made. And the sign flashed out its warning in the words that it was forming. And the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls. The tenement halls whispered. Silence.